Hello, my name is Marcus Hoffmann. I'm a grad student of the Technical University of Munich, and today I want to talk about simulation, modeling, and network-guided detection of epistasis. In the past, many studies were conducted on the heritability of height. Twin studies predicted about 80% of the heritability. Considering only independent genetic variants, can account for about 5% of the heritability. Both studies could not explain the full heritability of height. So most likely, epistasis could explain the missing heritability. Epistasis are interaction effects between multiple genetic variants. If we consider these two example SNPs separately, then we cannot observe any differences between case and control samples. But if we look at them together, we can. This means, together, we can associate these SNPs with the disease. In our work, we focus on three challenges. Firstly, we wanted to simulate data with a ground truth, as no real data with a ground truth is available. Secondly, we addressed some problems with the evaluation of existing statistical models. And thirdly, we focused on the problem that it is unclear how prior knowledge could be incorporated. Firstly, we developed EpiGen, an epistasis simulation pipeline. EpiGen is a realistic simulator of epistasis data with a ground truth. You can see the features of EpiGen in the table on the right side. EpiGen can faithfully reproduce many more characteristics of realistic data than other simulators. As a next step, our main idea is to split the optimization algorithm from the statistical epistasis model to evaluate only the model. As an input, we use epistasis instances with a ground truth SNP set. As a second input, our protocol requires random SNP sets. Then, we use the epistasis model to calculate scores. Afterwards, we perform a one-sided, one-sample t-test. As an output, we get a p-value for the epistasis model. As a second evaluation criterion, we want to include the scalability. For both evaluation criteria, we want to achieve the lowest possible score. On this slide, we listed the most commonly used statistical models in literature: the Bayesian, the variance, and the regression model. We now want to include a new statistical model. We call it the maximum likelihood model. In the beginning, the maximum likelihood model uses a standard penetrance table. A penetrance table contains the probability of expressing the phenotype under study given a particular allele combination. Then we test if enough samples are inside a cell. If yes, we calculate the maximum likelihood distribution of the cell. Otherwise, we use the previously calculated global maximum likelihood distribution. To calculate the score for a SNP set, we need to go over all samples and look at the likelihood for the phenotype at this sample, so at the maximum likelihood distribution for the genotype at this SNP set. The score is then the negative log likelihood over all samples. We used our newly developed evaluation protocol for the most common models in literature and compared them to the new maximum likelihood model. We think that the maximum likelihood model is the best compromise between runtime and quality. Next, we developed GenEpiSeeker, a yet unpublished tool for epistasis detection via local search. Our motivation was to find promising SNP sets by reducing the search space using biological knowledge. GenEpiSeeker uses a genotype and a phenotype matrix as an input. It also uses BioGrid as a PPI. We ship the required dbSNP and BioGrid information upon download. As a first step, GenEpiSeeker constructs a PPI-based SNP-SNP interaction network and conducts seeding afterwards. Then, the model we want to use is selected. GenEpiSeeker offers the models most commonly used in literature as well as the newly developed maximum likelihood model. GenEpiSeeker also supports multi-model approaches. Afterwards, GenEpiSeeker uses local search, including simulated annealing, to determine the best scoring snippets on the network. As an output, we retrieve candidate snippets. GenieBSeeker is not published yet. Here are some preliminary results for GenieBSeeker using the maximum likelihood model. To evaluate the impact of the PPI-based SNP-SNP interaction network, we generated a degree-preserving random network. In this plot, you can see the negative log likelihood score of the model on the x-axis and the occurrence of this score on the y-axis. The scores of the PPI-based SNP-SNP interaction network are smaller than the scores of the random network. These results are promising for the detection power of GenieBSeeker and the usage of a PPI-based SNP-SNP interaction network. Lastly, before I move on to the summary, I want to thank my research group for supporting this research. In summary, we can say that we made four contributions with our work. Firstly, EpiGen, an epistasis simulation pipeline which can simulate realistic data. Secondly, a new protocol for the evaluation of new epistasis models. This protocol separates the optimization algorithm and the statistical epistasis model from the epistasis detection tools, and only evaluates the epistasis model based on quality and runtime. Thirdly, a new epistasis model, the maximum likelihood model, which calculates maximum likelihood distributions for each cell of a penetrance table. And lastly, GenieBSeeker. GenieBSeeker builds a PPI-based SNP-SNP interaction network and uses local search to find epistatic interactions.